You shouldn't be thinking that I'm someone who knows everything, that I'm the guru. Well, one thing I can say is that no experience in life is useless. Every experience at some point, actually you find every experience you have had in life, you find it useful. 24 of us were announced as the National Australian Teaching Excellence Award winners. I tell you, any one of them could have won this. They're all, you know, excellent, dedicated, devoted university teachers. I knew that one of these 24 will be announced in the evening in the Parliament House. And to have won this is a great privilege. I guess a lot of the credits goes to my colleagues and my students who I have worked with over the last many years here in Australia and overseas. Basically, although it looks like an individual achievement, it's not. It's been a fascinating, wonderful feeling, yeah. Bit of surprise though.
I'm Lou Wilson. I'm the Program Director of the Undergraduate Program. I'll mainly be talking about undergraduate urban planning. If you are here for the Postgraduate Program, I can give you a little bit of information, but I suggest that you come with us after the talk down to the planning booth and I can give you more there. I'm here with Claire Woosman. Claire is one of our students and is very experienced in planning from the student perspective and also has work experience in the industry. So the two of us will be able to offer you some answers to any questions that you have about the program from either the teaching perspective or the student perspective after the talk. Okay, so you may sort of want to know, why would you want to study urban and regional planning in UniSA? Well, we're the longest established town planning program in South Australia, and we are the only undergraduate program that is accredited by the Planning Institute of Australia. Accreditation gives you significant advantages in the workplace, and the Professional Association also helps you keep up your skills and professional knowledge after graduation through seminars, programs and activities. We also have we also do world-class research in our discipline. We have we're recognised by the Commonwealth Government as one of the leading areas of urban and regional research in Australia. And we bring our research into the teaching. So the teaching and the coursework you'll do will be informed by the latest research. Now, if you're good at geography, history, social studies, economics, or you've thought about architecture, civil engineering, sociology, or environmental studies, if you really like meeting new people, if you like visiting different cities, and would you like to make the place a better world to live in, this is the course for you. We address topics like urban sprawl, traffic congestion, industrial pollution, and also we have a very strong emphasis now on adapting our cities to climate change and to making them more sustainable. We also have a social stream. We're into accessibility for people with disabilities to the city, social equality. We're very keen on teaching about housing affordability and how to make housing affordable. And we have an emphasis on environmental protection. Planners can go into the environmental protection field, and we will teach you about environmental planning and the protection of natural environments, and of course also our built heritage as well. But really what planning is about is a sense of place and identity. Now, most great cities in the world have iconic structures. Rio has the great Statue of Christ, Paris has the Eiffel Tower, Sydney has the Opera House, and of course New York has the Empire State Building. In Adelaide we've got, you know, we've got the Popeye on the Torrens. Now, you know, people might laugh a little bit about the Popeye, but my brother had his 40th birthday on the Popeye. I personally felt it was a little childish, but he, you know, had a great sense of attachment to it because he'd had many happy memories of it. And much of what we do in planning is about dealing with that sense of place and identity, which all of us have for the places we grow up in and the places we live in and want to be part of. And we're about planning for that sense of place and identity and making cities livable and places where people want to be. Sorry, I'm not used to this setup. Now, Adelaide itself is a very beautiful city. We do perhaps lack the icons that Sydney does and New York has and Paris. But we have a great cultural precinct along North Terrace. We have beautiful beaches. We have the Gunnell District. We have Rundle Street East, and we have the mall, and we have many other nice parts of the city. And what we do is about keeping the city looking great and making it even better. And your course will be taught at the City East campus, which is close to the Rundle Mall precinct and to the City East precinct. So you can actually sit and have coffee while you're studying and think about urban design issues. It's a very pleasant place to study. And you'll be thinking about how you can make cities places for people, how you can design better cities and make them more environmentally friendly and socially sustainable and economically strong. Here are the entry requirements. The SATAC tertiary entry rank, the ATAR for 2011, was 66.8. That's really not, that doesn't mean that much. It is the last person through the door the year before. But it should be around that figure. It'd probably be a little bit higher, a little bit lower, probably a little bit higher. But don't let that put you off if you want to come into planning and you haven't got that score. There are other ways that you can boost your score. Among them is the STAT test, which is available for this program. You can do the STAT test now from 18. We also offer bonus points, and I'm not going to go into the intricacies of that. I'll just put the slide up. If you want to talk about bonus points, a good way to go is to come and see me after the talk, and I can go through it with you, and I can introduce you to our general manager, who will be able to give you very accurate information in terms of what you need in order to get into our program or into any of the other programs ITEE offers at the University of South Australia. So come along with me after the talk if you're interested in talking about bonus points. And I can show you other ways of getting into. Here's our program structure. We're a 4-year full-time professional degree. We offer a 12-week work placement in a planning agency, which we will find for you. You can, if you wish, find your own placement, but we will find one for you if you can't, and we can place you in an agency where you want to work. So if you tell us the kind of field of planning you want to go into, we will find you a placement in that field in Adelaide. And this is a very useful thing to have as part of the program. We find is that many of our students receive part-time work, paid part-time work as part of their work placement. And when they enter the fourth year of their degree, they're often working part-time in the industry. And that is very useful in terms of translating those roles into full-time jobs when they finish their degree at the end of 4 years. We're based at the City East campus, a lovely campus down next to the Adelaide University, just up North Terrace from here, close to the City East CAF zone. We offer 2 program majors. You can major in social and community planning or environmental planning. Or, if you wish, you can just do general planning. You don't have to do either of those majors. They're just options if you want to specialise in those fields. We will teach you about environmental planning, about studying for sustainable cities, urban design. We'll give you a good grounding in social issues and social planning if you want to work in community development. And we'll give you a grounding in urban analysis and planning law, among other topics. The first year begins with a very strong grounding in the basics of planning. We introduce you to the notion of planning, what it's about, what cities and regions are about, and we give you an environmental perspective and introduce you to geographic information systems. Has anyone out there use Google Maps? Okay, Google Earth? Okay, so what's Google Maps involve? Basically, you type an address in and it brings up a route or something like that. Okay, well, GIS is the program behind Google Maps, so we will teach you about Google Maps and how to use them, how to design them and so forth as part of that course. In semester 2, in study period 5, We'll introduce you to Heritage Workshop, which is about Adelaide's heritage and concepts such as the Garden City. And you'll do field trips around Adelaide to see particularly interesting developments and historical developments from the past that are part of our built heritage. We also introduce you to infrastructure planning and land use planning as part of that that coursework in semester two of the first year. In second year, we move along and introduce you to community development planning through social and community planning. We give you a grounding in research methods, in analytic methods for planning. And we introduce you to urban design. If you're interested in design, if you have an architectural bent, planning involves quite a lot of design work, and we're about designing towns and cities. Architects design buildings, we design towns, we're town planners. In second semester, we'll give you an introduction to property economics and policy and development. And then moving into third year, we start preparing you for going out into your work placement in the third year, at the end of the third year in semester two. In study period two, that's semester one, we'll teach you about planning law, which you'll need to use when you go into the field. And we'll give you a bit more about the kind of methods you can use in social and community planning and in regional planning. And you'll do a policy and development assessment workshop to help you get into development assessment. Development assessment is something like 40% of the jobs in planning, so that's a very important component. And that will prepare you for planning field placement. Planning field placement involves you working as a planner under supervision for a semester. And you will do some coursework with us back at the uni to make sure that you're on track. But you'll primarily be working in the field with real planners, acting and working as a planner. And as I've said earlier, it's great for getting work. It's one of the strengths of our program. Most other degrees don't offer you this kind of thing. Other degrees that do offer you this expect you to go and find the placement yourself. We'll find it for you. Although you can, if you wish, look for your own placement. If there's a particular place you want to go, that's fine with us. Otherwise, we'll help you. It's great for getting references and it's great for getting experience. When you come out of it, you'll be virtually a trained planner. Fourth year is our honours year. About two-thirds of the class do honours. Honours is for academically gifted students. We have a very strong teaching program, so something like two-thirds of our students go on to do honours. Honours involves doing a research dissertation at 15,000 words. Students who do it can go into careers as research officers or project officers as an alternative to planning. And we also had significant success in recent years because of the high quality research we do in planning at UniSA in getting our honours students Commonwealth scholarships. And we currently have about 15 students in the school who are studying for PhDs full-time on Commonwealth scholarships. The scholarships are worth about $27,000 a year tax-free, and you're studying for a higher degree. The higher degrees lead into jobs in the 80,000 to 90,000 range, going up into the 100,000 range. So it's a way to go if you want to do some further study and you're not feeling like working, or if you want to come back to it, you can do it. People often come back and do a PhD 3, 5, 10 years down the track. It gives you another option that's associated with this degree. It's a very good one. If you don't do honours, you do some research work as well. We teach you research methods, and you will do a shorter project, and you'll still get those skills. You just won't be doing honours. We offer some postgraduate programs. If you're looking for a postgraduate, we have a one-year grad diploma, and we also have a two-year master's. Many people choose to move on from the grad diploma into the master's. The grad diploma is the first year of the master's program, so if you have done the grad diploma and you feel like doing more study, you can continue on and get a master's without having to do it all again. If you want more information about the postgrad programs, please come down to the booth after the talk. Once you go through our program, you'll have skills in urban planning and you'll have knowledge of urban planning. We'll give you a good grounding in social and community planning, in environmental planning, in urban design. We'll give you good critical thinking skills. We'll give you those research skills that you can use to get alternative jobs. You can go into policy formulation. There's currently 150 policy jobs vacant in the state government if you are looking for that sort of work. There's also many planning jobs. 98% of our graduates will get work within 3 months of graduating. As I said, most of them are actually working in the field before they graduate. We will teach you about consultation, mediation and negotiation, and we'll give you very good oral and written communication skills. You'll be able to write reports, you'll be able to do presentations, you'll be able to do all the things you need to succeed as a professional. Most importantly, we'll give you a holistic understanding of urban and regional planning, and we will set you up for a career in our discipline, which will lead you very far. One of our recent graduates from 2 years ago, Elise Harris, her first job was in Singapore. Then a few months later, she went to work in San Francisco, and then she went on to work at the World Bank in Washington for 6 months. Then she went to work in Beijing. Now she's working in KL, and she's done all that in 2 years, and she's now on $95,000 a year. You don't need to do that. Other people are quite happy working for the Adelaide City Council or for state government departments, or they can work for private consultancies around Adelaide. Or if you're from regional South Australia, there are many jobs in the country for planners. Planning is a really good degree if you wish to work in regional areas. There's a big shortage of planners in regional areas. There's also a shortage of planners nationally. Doing your degree will get you into that field, get you a good job with high pay. Now, the starting salary, you can look this up on PayScale Australia. I haven't checked it this year. Last year it started at $53,000. We have lots of reports back from the field that most of our graduates within 2 years move into the mid-70s. The starting salary figure is actually up there on the web if you want to look at it. We have very strong local international employment opportunities, as already mentioned. And you can work in a vast array of industries. You can work in local government, state government, federal government, private planning agencies, you can work for construction firms, mining companies, and you can work interstate in regional areas within the city of Adelaide itself. Most planners that graduate from our course work within Adelaide. But you can also work in national park planning, in coastal protection and heritage conservation, community development and many other fields. And increasingly our graduates are moving into international appointments. I've already mentioned Elise Harris, and that's an option that's open to you as well. If you're interested in any of these opportunities and what might come afterwards, please come and see Claire and myself at the planning booth after the talk if you don't get a chance to ask a question after I've finished speaking now. We also offer some very attractive student exchange options. These are options, you don't necessarily have to do these, but if you wish to, you can study abroad at a number of partner universities. We have partnership arrangements with Roskilde University in Copenhagen. All the courses are taught in English. The university is about 20 minutes on the train from downtown Copenhagen, very close to Sweden, Germany, France and so forth. Great for seeing Europe. Most of our graduates who go there, we have about 4 or 5 a year going. It generally takes a little bit of extra time to look around, as you would. But if you just want to stay in Copenhagen and you go in the first half of the year, there was a great music festival at the end of the semester, which many people like. And Copenhagen itself is a beautiful city. There is the Tivoli Gardens, the Royal Palace. You might bump into, you know, Fred and Mary in the street. And there's the Little Mermaid, of course, and the CAF districts. We also have opportunities for study in Canada, in the United States, China, Hong Kong, and Japan. And there are some opportunities also in the UK. And if you want to talk about those opportunities, please come and see me later. They're options, they're not compulsory, only if you wish to do it. We will offer you a $2,500 travel grant if you wish to take an international study visit. And there are some top-up scholarships for $5,000 each. And you'll receive Aus-Study from the federal government, even if you're not eligible for it here. The study you do abroad will be credited for a full study at UniSA, so, and it won't cost you anything. In the fourth year of our program, we also offer a fully escorted 2-week study visit of Penang in Malaysia, where you work with Malaysian students for a fortnight. And this is a group of students as part of a course, so you'll be doing that as a formal course with 20 others, and learning about the history and heritage of Penang and the planning issues over there. We are the only program, undergraduate program, that's recognised by the Planning Institute of Australia. The Planning Institute recognition and accreditation gives you significant advantages in the workplace. It also helps you maintain professional standards once you leave the workplace. They run seminars, cultural events, planning activities, keep you up to date with your profession. It's a good thing to be part of. Now here's a bit of a summary of the special features. I've already mentioned the TER and the very close links we have with state and local government. We have a planning advisory board which consists of members of most state government departments that employ planners and people from private industry. They advise us on the course, how we keep it relevant, how we keep in touch with the field. We have these very, very significant 12-week field placements in third year which will help you get into work. We give you great study abroad opportunities. And we also offer the only planning degree in South Australia that is accredited by the Planning Institute of Australia. So are there any questions about these matters?
I have a question about the travel. What do you suggest?
Yes. Well, UniSA will not allow you to go in first year. You're meant to become a little bit more mature. Because you're meant to be, you know, representing the university. You can go from anywhere in second, third or fourth year. A lot of people like to go either in the last half of second year or the first half of third year. And you can also do more than one. We have a guy who went to Roskilde. He then went on and did a placement in Turkey, in Istanbul. He was very adventurous. He did the first placement in the third year of his degree and the second one in fourth year. If you do it in fourth year, you just have to negotiate a research project that you would do as part of your study visit in the fourth year. Sure.
How long are those trips for?
Oh, one semester.
One semester.
13, 14 weeks. And most people go a bit longer because they want to see because you get the airfare and everything for free. So most people like to, you know, spend a few more months over there if they can, so that. Basically, they'll go before the semester starts and come back after. And it's up to you when you come back. Any more questions? Sure. Yes, English is a good one to have. Geography, if you've got a geography, if you've got it, social science, if you've got it, education. It never hurts if you've got maths, but it's not critical for this course. It's more of a social science course, if you like. If you've got economics, it's a good way to go. It's a geography, social science, economics type background course. But if you want more information, we can talk to you about that afterwards as well. Are there any more questions? Are there any questions of Claire? Claire is a student of ours. She's nearly completed the degree.
No, I'm heading off to Penang in about 3 weeks. I'll be doing the Malaysian trip. But a few students in my course, probably the 8, went overseas. 4 went to Denmark and 2 went to Canada. 1 went to Hong Kong. And 1 stayed on. Did a bit of travelling throughout the summer and did his placement in the City of London. So some amazing opportunities over there.
Yeah, they're quite good for building networks too, those programs. You can meet lots of planners from international backgrounds, which are useful later on in your career as well, and make lots of friends too. They're optional though. Not everyone does them. Yeah, it's only if you really want to do that kind of thing. We have a couple of weeks' time, we've got a City East Preview Day coming up. If you want to come to that, we're going to offer you lunch. It's a good deal. And if you register for it, you can be in a draw for an Xbox game. I don't know what an Xbox game is, because I'm old, I admit it, I'm a Luddite, you know. But you can win the game and come along and have some lunch. We're going to have 2 planners from the field coming in, Melissa Bailey and Kirsten Potoski, and they will be running a planning exercise. They will show you what planners do from the perspectives of people who work in the field. So it's a good hands-on. If you're a bit unsure about what planning's about, you can actually see firsthand how it works from people who actually do planning. We'll also have a bit of a talk and give you more information. There'll be a chance to meet some of the teaching staff in a less crowded environment. And you can also have a look around the City East campus and the facilities we have down there for the students. The campus is a lovely campus. It's down adjacent to the Adelaide University, further up North Terrace, and very close to public transport and, of course, the facilities around North Terrace. So are there any more questions? Yes, we have small classes. We only have an intake of about 45 or 50 most years, about the number of people in this room. We normally have a large number of tutorial staff, so we would have basically classes around 10 to 15. We like to keep the classes small. Planning involves a lot of intensive hands-on work in the latter stages. It's also intellectually rigorous, so there's a need for small classes so that people get a good grounding in the theory of planning as well as the practice. And it's generally very social. Claire is a former president of OOPS. What's OOPS?
Social events.
Yeah.
So we guess we just deal with a lot of social events and get all the students to come along. We do a few pub crawls throughout the year. So we do our end of year and mid-year pub crawl. So we also do maybe some barbecues throughout the year as well, and just get everyone in together and interacting and go out and have some fun. Yeah, it's good fun. Meet a lot of networking that way as well, so you can meet a lot of planners in the industry, come out and have a chat to the students and see where you're at, and they remember you and give you a bit of placement and some work, so it's good opportunities that way as well.
Yeah, we're very big on building social capital. Social capital is associated with the concept of planning, and what we need to do is to get you networking with people in the industry from the very beginning, and the OOPS and the social events that we organise as part of it give you that opportunity to mingle with people from the industry, which you can then build on when you do your work placement. Is why we have such a high employment rate, because we do that strong encouragement of networking throughout the course and the program. How would you describe the course, Claire? Did you have a good experience?
Yeah, no, I've had a good experience. So placement was probably one of my experiences. I did my Adelaide Council and made a few networks out of that way and did some work, and I guess the work that you do there, it's a good opportunity to apply what you've started learning at university and apply it to the work that you're doing at council. There's not just opportunities, I guess, in council. You can work for state government and private firms and government agencies, and it's definitely, if you're interested in development and working community, it's something, a career that you definitely enjoy. So, does anyone actually have any questions about placement at all, the work that you do, or at all about planning?
It's do you want to come up here? A placement is quite a useful thing to know about if you're thinking about going out there.
Anyone have anything at all? So, well, I'll just say a little bit about my placement. I just did a 6-month placement. I did 3 months in development assessment, so assessing applications. I did a few around the city, a couple in Rundle Mall, and then I did 3 months in planning policy. So I actually worked on a development plan amendment in the actual Adelaide City Council development plan, and that was the liquor licensing one. So I did a bit on crime prevention and looked at community impact, and so hopefully that's somewhere I'd really like to focus my career on and definitely go that path. Does anyone have any questions about placement, workload at all? Like, I'm here, I know what I was like when I was sitting over there and I was bursting with questions, so if anyone has anything, I'm all ears. Yeah, our first year is about 13 hours, contact hours. That usually runs throughout the 3 years, and I'm doing my honours degree at the moment, and we're going to university about once a month at the moment while we're writing our honours thesis. So,
but there is you have to do about 2 or 3 times that course outside of the contact hours, homework.
So any questions about assignments or anything? The assignments that we do, we roughly do about 3 assignments per course. Usually you do 1 group assignment presentation per course. and the rest are written assignments. Usually the word limits maybe around 2,000 or something per assignment.
Yeah, the other aspect of it is because we're a small teaching unit, and if you are struggling with coursework, you can come and see the staff and we'll try and get you through. We have very few people that actually drop out. We try to keep everyone. And we pride ourselves on being accessible. The doors are always open. You can pretty well knock on a door, can't you?
Yeah, no, they're always very willing to help out. When you're doing your honours thesis, you get allocated a supervisor, and they're always easily approachable. Go into the office and ask any questions. And same with first year, you've got, I think it's learning and teaching unit. If you're having any troubles, you can hop in and go down there, and they can help you out with the assignments if you're having any troubles at all. So, yeah. Master's degree.
Yes, we're building one in. Yeah, come and see us afterwards and we can tell you. Last chance, we have to go soon. Look, I do want to plug this. We're about to wrap up now. We have to leave in a minute or two. But I do want to plug this City East preview day we're having. You can learn a lot more about it in a much more quieter atmosphere. We can introduce you to the teaching staff. You can win an Xbox. It's good. And we give you free lunch, even better. So I'm not sure how you register, because the pamphlet we've got, we forgot to put on it how to register. That was probably an example of poor planning. But if you want to do a search for the City East Preview Day on the UniSA website, you'll find the registration page, which I believe is open. So please register for your name so we know how many people to cater for. And please come along and have lunch with us in the chat. And take care, and we'll be at the planning booth for the rest of the afternoon if you want to talk to us.